Stai.
Ce e asta?
David, you want eating?
I'm not ready to get changed.
No, you want
it? I need a peek first.
Yeah. Mulțumesc. Stai, tata să râite. Asta, da, David.
Și de asta, axianoni.
Iute. Așa. Tata să facă o poză. Ia nărat, omul.
Mamă, zic.
Dar scoate chipșonul.
Da.
Și ce vrei tu acum?
E așa deschid.
Hai. Îți place? Stai. Nu.
Mașina îți gătește de bunci. Înțeles? Da. Pe urmă.
David, cum faci mașina? Hai, spune.
Bun.
Mai tare, fă-ți tare. Ia,
sunt efecte, hai să ne râs.
Hai,
am
cum faci mașina?
David să așeze și să facă raleuri.
Da, și cum o să facă mașina?
Da?
Ce-i acolo?
Arată cum tata ieri se arată așa, arată. Două dești desfăcute. Arată. Ia,
uite, cum faci mașina? Ia, pe bun, bun. Cum faci mașina?
Bun, 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 bun.
Be happy boy now.
Ia uite ce mașină vine acolo. Uite ce mașină treci. Ia-te, uite. Vezi? Buxa. Cu cran, bucșa, așa-i?
Da!
Ca bucșa! Mergem! Adia, fuga! Uite-te mașinile, vine și tata! Da, asta?
we have judged their position on the racetrack as carefully as they possibly can. Down to Woodward once again comes in. They're important. They are sitting in. Where's their third line? Are living fourth position. Gibbs, Miles, Sargent, Foreman. That's who offered the moment. Although that fifth position battle's getting tighter and tighter. Gibbs, Miles, and Sargent are incredibly close together. Gibbs is just about hanging on to it, but Sargent is really in Miles. He's got a great opportunity to get off the final turn. As Webb continues to hold on, still trying to get himself out of the top five, but it won't be long at this rate before he gets past Gibbs. He's a second quicker than him on the last lap. In fact, there's only two drivers on the track. He's one quicker than him on the last lap. That was 4.5. That was away from first and second place. And as finished, would be quicker than him if he could get into clear track. And then he has just managed to do that. He's got into fifth position. So now he's got clear track in front of him. He's got a little bit of time, about 2.5 seconds or so to make up on Webb and Harmer. But if he comes back in pace, he will do that before too long. So Morton Lincoln, Harms in second, Webb in third, Harmer in fourth place. Then he's Gibbs, Sanders, Miles, Foreman's in position still. Nice boy, he's trying to hold on to it all his efforts. And then we've got this incredible battle for 10th position as Webb again tries to hold on. He's sort of battling away. 4/10 of a second between them. Sanders did 1:12.3 to make him the fastest man on the track in that last lap. So he's already starting to drop the gap. He's got 2.4 seconds from Webb and Harmer in the 4th place. Also leading at half his front behind his 2nd position. Then it's Webb and Harmer still going to the line. And then closing off both of them is Sanders in 5th position. This seems to be a really close battle, this one. So back out of the last field and through Woodcote for the 6th time. At the end of lap 6, 1.75 minutes to go. Harding leading 7 on the attack on Porter. He's got a good run and it looks as though Porter is having to defend to the inside line. He knows that Hart is going to be faster than him on the straight, so he holds the inside line to defend. An interesting battle between those 3 or 4 cars at the tail end, Charlie. Really exciting stuff.
Arată unii vedem.
Porter and Hart separating by 0.1 of a second with Hart getting his own turn from a flat. A 1:12.3 grabbing away from position. Oh, back in steps out there, big time for Miles. He almost loses the car completely. He somehow catches it before the car goes wrong. Foreman gets on the new bike right. This is exactly what he's doing now. Don't forget to go back side by side. Still going to be battling all the way around Woodcote. But he has a near 9th place and Paris leading that 10th position squabble to 10.6 seconds. So it's opened up a little bit there between those two. Sanders is now right on the back of them, so he's managed to get that gap down for a long way to right in the firing line. So it was 2.5 seconds when he managed to get himself into fifth position. It was 1.1 seconds last time, it's a lot less than that this time, and Webb defends to the inside. He knows that Harland is there, he knows he's got a good line up Woodcote. He's going to go very fast alongside him. Webb is actually looking like he's got a problem, maybe. Did he use a gear on the way out of Longfield? Because he's going to have round the outside, through goes Harland. And he gets through into third position. Absolutely brilliant work from Cohen in the last few laps. But the 50 is there on merit in 11th position, fighting hard. And no surprises there, really. He started 10th on the grid and dropped his way back. So now Cohen is basically on the comeback charge. Back to the front of the field. And all three of these cars back to third position. As long as they get chance to go the whole way round, skip past Webb and they bang doors as they go through Brooklands. Now they go through Longfield. Webb holds his inside line. He's not going to allow Sanders a chance to get through. Meanwhile, Hart is going to go for a position for the lead here. Porter, he's not quite close enough to challenge. Sanders is all over the back of Webb, though. He tries to go to the inside line. Webb is not going to give him a lot of room to pit while he goes. And Webb, leaving in the smallest possible gap, he now moves back across the left hand side.
David,
coming through. Great battle this for the victory. Porter
David,
and then Harper, Webb and Sanders. Black and white flag has got out for the 63 of Gibbs. Harris is now in 10th position. Cohen is up to 11th, 15th and 16th place, waiting for an opportunity to pass. Back down the lane, straight and into Brooklyn. Porter and Hart again scrapping away for victory. Hart still waiting for his opportune moment. Harmer there in 3rd position has been done. Webb in 4th, Sanders in 5th. Again, he tries an opportunistic move, but he can't quite get close enough to the rear bumper. And the squabble for 6th position has tightened up because it's now a 4-way scrap. Abbott has caught up to the back of these three, Gibbs, Foreman and Miles. So it's really going strong for them. Porter, Hart, Hartman, Webb and Sanders. And then it's a 4-way scrap for 6th position. They're side by side, 6th and 7th place. As on the inside, Foreman is going to take back his 6th position from the 63 of Gibbs. And Miles is going to get an opportunity to look up the inside as well. He might get past both of them here. They're side by side on the door. Can he get in line up the inside? He's going to get past both of them, is he? Almost round the outside. Big challenge for his way through. So back down to Brooklyn's turn. Up towards Starfield once again. The leaders are coming through. Porter of Hearts. Still the same order. They lost time to the three men behind, but they're still scrapping away for that third position. It's definitely not done yet. The Sun is desperately trying to get himself back up into the lead, but he's heavily running out of time. We're just on 7 minutes to go. He's got the fastest car on the track. He proved that in qualifying, but he just can't get by these two cars in front of him. And he's hemorrhaging time to Porter of Hearts while he sits behind him in fifth place. Meanwhile, seventh and eighth position side by side. Gibbs has got himself back in sixth place. And now Harvick has to defend the Foreman. Hammond is there in ninth position, sitting and watching. Foreman and Harvick are still side by side, still battling down the straight. And again, Foreman has to shut the door on Harvick. So that number 10 is definitely getting himself into battle position. But he couldn't quite manage to keep his Foreman at bay that time round. Meanwhile, Covid is closing in on Paris. And then we look back, and it's finally starting to settle down a little bit in the battle. Safe and sound in the positions they're in as they pick their way through Cops Corner one more time. We're on the 12th lap of this 20-minute race and still on the whole line in front of Hearts. We look back to third, fourth and fifth, and it's Harper from Webb and Sardis. Sardis again getting very aggressive and breaking zone there down towards the left field. He's not quite close enough to make an overtaking move, but he gets a good line through the next part of the course. He might just have an opportunity. It's further back, a little bit of a wayward moment there for Miles, who runs a little bit wide Brooklands, and he manages to hold the inside line to defend through Luffield, but he still has Foreman to his left, so he's got to be very careful. Meanwhile, Sardis is getting on with it in the top corner, trying to get past Webb. Webb defends, and he can't get by, but Foreman is side by side with Miles, and Foreman back down the strike there. So close indeed, up towards the breaking point. Who is going to break first? Miles is going to hold it to the inside line, no fight around the outside. Foreman holds it. Beautiful overtaking move there from Foreman as he manages to pull out Brooklands one more. Still leads to Porter of Hearts, then it's Hartland, and up to fourth position has gone Sardis. He must have done that on the far side of the circuit, but Sardis is now through to fourth place. Once a breath, now this keeps him in a bit of space. He's got plenty air. He can make a challenge towards Hartland and try and get himself at least on the podium. If not, he can go after the first two cars in the mix. But it's still Porter of Hearts. Hartland in third, Sardis in fifth. Then we look back to sixth position, it's Gibbs. He's got a tiny bit of a gap between himself and the fourth place. The Foreman is there in front of Alistair Miles, and the 83 is there as well. Dan Aaron trying to hold him on top of it. He started in position on the grid, but he's not quite able to run with these guys on pure the second of the TK cars. The 75. Chatterton almost got him there on the way down the run out of Woodco into Cops Corner, but he manages to hold on to the line. Meanwhile, back towards Brooklands. Porter of Hearts is still stepping away from the lead. Sardis is making a move round the outside. Brooklands can get the move stuck. Yes, he's through in the best position. And now Webb is going to try and get on the inside of Harper as they come out of Ruffield. It's going to be very close indeed. They bang wheels. And it looks as though Sardis is going to have to get away from these two pretty quickly because they've got a good run on him out of Woodco. Sardis is into third position. This is exactly where he wanted to be. He's only got 3 minutes to try and close up on the two guys in front. I doubt he'll manage that in the time. He's got to go and challenge from behind as well. Hold the chance to throw it at the inside of Cox. He's got to be careful. He can't align on the way out of the corner because Webb will be all over him like a mad habit. As Foreman has managed to get past Gibbs on the last lap as well. Although Gibbs is fighting back into Cox's corner, Foreman rushed up from Chatterton. Nothing doing for Wesley Chatterton, unfortunately. He just can't quite seem to get the moves up. Meanwhile, back to Brooklyn's turn and into the left hand they go forward. He's still following his every move. There's not much to choose between them. Sardis is desperately trying to drop Harland and Webb. And maybe he might have an opportunity to get close to these two on this run. I don't think he's going to have enough time to get into the lead of the race, though. We've got just under 2 minutes to go, so I make it two laps to go as Porter and Hearts come across the line. So they continue their run. Sardis in third, Harland in fourth, Webb in fifth, and they're starting to separate those three. Meanwhile, sixth position is still anybody's guess. Foreman, Gibbs, Miles and Hammond are in an absolutely cracking scrap. Miles is having to have a look at Now Breed has got that through again. Sorry, Chatterton in front of Webb. third position. Really decimated the gap to our front. Three for the second out of the last lap. He's going to run out of time, unfortunately, though, as we go into the last lap. It's going to be just about, well, it's close enough. It's close, but not quite close enough. This is the longer of the two races, of course. 20 minutes compared to the 15-minute encounter we'll have later on for these guys. But we're into the last lap, so we're going to be very difficult for Sanders to push on. The checkered flag is being ready down in pit lane. Art in second, Sanders in third, and I think that is the way it's going to stay. It's going to be Paul Parkin who waves the flag as they come home. And I think that's one lap to try and get that position back again. But Paul Parkin controls this race valiantly all the way throughout. He comes into progress for the last time through that field one, through field two. Well, I suppose it was up in one or two, but it's now just one long flowing hairpin now. I'm going old school there. Out to Bluffield, and through Wickham for the last time. Porter is going to hold this one in front of Parkin with half a second ahead. Series. Porter wins it, Haas in second, Sanders fights back to third, Hartland is fourth place with the championship leader Chris Webb in fifth position. I think perhaps the championship might not be so much just yet. Sixth position, Paul McCartney in one star after a great fight, Gibbs in seventh place, in front of Allen, finally got out of step miles on the last lap. Good battle between those two, and he sorted it out right at the bitter end there. Tenth position is going to come through 45, that will be a nice end to the day for David Paris. He rounds up the top 10 in front of the first of our cross speed race of the weekend then in the form of the 42 of Ian Green, who clearly came together at some point around the circuit, but that's then Lindsay, unless it was a related incident, but we're not entirely sure. We'll have to figure that one out a little bit later on. Well, an absolutely fantastic victory, yeah, no doubt. James Peter Dennis will be able to talk us through the top three drivers at the end of an absolutely thrilling race. Porter manages to control the pace throughout. They're just kind of making their way through Nuffield. It almost looked as though Porter unconsciously racing against the side by side, and Porter was very much on the edge there, but a nice blink of the headlights as the first one of Ian Porter comes into the pits, followed by the rest of the field, and he'll be very delighted with that one, to be fair, considering he started this race in fourth position on the grid. He made good use of his start, he got himself into a bringing position, and he just controlled the pace in front of Adam Hart. Very nicely done there from Nick Porter, and it's Jimmy Peters-Ennis, he's going to bring them down to the pit lane. I am, yes, going to be talking to the top three, and also winner of the 8-pound class as well. Bring them all in. In fact, we're going to talk to the top four.
Дежурочку мы сняли, ли?
Да.
Ты шаровали. Давид, я тебя шо, я чем убей. Я-ка шо. Что ты где, вали, тебе вали? Hey, what's up?
Defended well there by the Global Racing car 188. So were some great battles. But meanwhile, the Honeywell car and the Traktor Domino's machine are trying to battle their way past the Viking self-storage. That was close for Wheeldon. The car slipped away as he darted for the inside line. A triangle line in the...